La 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 la, this is Kat.
And this is Kido.
And this is Remember Me. Do you remember me? I remember me.
Not quite. But yeah, so
let's
this
go
is episode two. If you guys are seeing episode two, that only means one thing. The copyright thing was not an issue. That means you also saw episode one. So congratulations.
Unless you skipped episode one, then I don't like you.
I mean, they won't do that because episode one's going to come out before episode two. Yeah, I haven't even released.
I mean, some people do skip. Like, I skip a few episodes of some series because it gets boring.
I haven't released episode one yet because we had issues that would like lead to potential interruptions. So now that those interruptions are now, you know, ceased, you'll see more of this now.
You know, this place is like a barren wasteland.
It is a barren wasteland.
Like
an urban wasteland.
Urban wasteland, yes. Kind of like a broke Tokyo.
Huh.
You see it, right? You see the broke Tokyo in this?
To that warehouse. I guess that
it's a shortcut. Oh, man, it's Mr. Edgemaster. Hey, Shadow. I wish I could see his face.
Alright, so now where to?
I don't want to walk.
I don't think it's a good idea.
If this wasn't a free parkour game.
This isn't Mirror's Edge, Cat.
This is Mirror's Edge,
in a way. I mean, similarities are here and there. I mean, I've never seen the Mirror Edge Girls.
Derriere?
Yeah.
Oh, hi, guy. Oh, yeah, another chick. I'm sorry.
Sorry for assuming your gender like that.
I didn't mean to assume your gender!
Yes, you did.
Don't Tumblr shame me.
Elsewhere. You meant every. Alright. Mm. There's some pretty nicely sculpted crates under there. Down the ladder.
Those crates are retarded.
Hey.
And I mean that in the stupid way.
Well, I mean, the term retarded itself is just insulting altogether.
I mean, like, oh, any word can be called insulting, you freaking dandelion.
I feel insulted by that somehow.
Exactly, see? I like how brave she is to just jump from one spot to another.
I mean, she used to be like a hunter or some shit, right? So she had to do that a lot.
Yeah, but like she doesn't have the memory anymore, so.
But she's, you know, her body still is like used to that kind of stuff.
And then just jumping into danger like this, man.
Oh. I just wanted some coffee!
Your coffee is terrible!
Oh, well, why are you attacking me?
Cause your coffee was terrible!
Oh, yeah, he's not getting up, is he?
What was that thing?
That's a good sign.
I assume not. Yeah,
he's gone. He's quite gone.
You're almost there.
Made that.
Follow Tommy's flying drones to his bar.
What the hell is that thing?
Oh, it's a flying drone. I need to follow it.
I see.
You're just distrusting of your own body.
Yeah,
I've been pressing up the entire time. I'm sorry. That was my intention.
I mean, I have no idea what's going on at all, so, you know.
Ah, Selenia!
God damn it.
I almost got Simba!
Well, Mufasa. Because Mufasa was the one that fell.
Nah, I'm pretty sure Simba's
kid.
Simba's kid did it off screen. You didn't see the second movie. There is a second movie.
I saw the second movie and that did not happen.
I need to get a running start. I need to get a running start. I need to get... Now! What was the lesson we learned here today?
Guys...
Always judge your jumps.
No, I think the real lesson here is Kat's a fucking idiot.
It's not my fault that she was slightly off by like 5 kilometers.
You didn't even look to see what was going. You just went and jumped. No, and you carefully timed the shorter jump, but then you don't even assess the bigger one. No. Okay, all right. So look.
See, like I was a kilometer.
That's
off.
What you didn't.
No, it's
do.
Only a kilometer off, man.
That's what you didn't do.
Listen, man, don't judge my jumps. My jumps are good. You can judge my jumps now. I'm sorry. I'm a bad liar, okay? We all established that. Nope.
Stop.
Sorry. Oh, yeah, I'm just awesome like this, yes.
Good.
Well,
am I supposed to go down?
No going back.
I think that is a yes. Got you.
Alright.
Got you, dude.
Whew, today was really hot, so if we're not talking too much, we apologize for that, but,
Oh, yeah, because we had to turn the air conditioner off for this.
Yeah.
We're dying for your comfort.
Yeah, we have some pretty dry taste buds right now.
Well, actually, you do. I have a lemon lime right here.
Yeah. Yeah, you know what I'm going to have after this recording? A nice tall glass of water. You know, the stuff you're supposed to drink.
I remember my days back when they were seeing everybody was just singing. There's some good sailors, too, but, you know, they're...
We're gonna pretend like Cat never said anything about
that. I mean, like, I wasn't being dirty.
Men at sea. That's what you meant by semen.
Yeah. There were semen everywhere. Because there was a time where Chicago was a water city. Yeah.
You know, that doesn't make anything any better. You tried your best to make it a good cover up. You did. You did, but you failed miserably.
I work, all right. Unlike you.
Hey.
You broken CD player.
Damn.
I'm looking for an Easter egg.
No one even uses CD players anymore, man. It makes me feel even worse.
Hold on, wait. There's an Easter egg. Fix yourself up a little.
What was it?
I don't know. No big
mam junkie. Look, headache Tommy.
Johnny wants my heart for Christmas. You know that, huh, Tommy?
You're safe here, Bob. Don't sweat it.
Well, I'll be. Edge did it. Come here, sweetheart.
Nilin, it seems like a lifetime.
I'm sorry. I have no memory of you.
You really can't remember this pretty boy face of mine?
I'm sorry.
You keep telling yourself that, sweetheart.
Hell. Well, we all lost bits and pieces in the war. But you're free, sweetheart. That's what counts.
I guess. Feels like I'm lost.
First things first, sister. Let's get you out of those straps.
About this game.
I mean... Generally, people say this game is pretty good. It's just, you know, this game is also pretty hard. So a lot of people don't like talking about it because they probably didn't get a chance to beat it.
I think it was another game that came out the same time this came out.
Yeah. I might have to look back into that. You know,
I think this was Under Shadow, like a lot of good games.
Yeah, I think a lot of games that came out in 2000. This game came out in 2009, right?
I think so, maybe. Let me check it from your
safe house. Or maybe it was 2012 or something. I think it was 2012, maybe. 2011.
It was. I don't even know where
Because
100%.
I think you know a lot of other games came out that kind of just left this one in the dust.
Exactly. I think Mirror's Edge was one of the games that came out.
I think that had to have been it. If not, I'm gonna look into this actually. I'm gonna look into this.
Mirror's Edge, Assassin's Creed. I think all those games.
Yeah, those games probably overshadowed.
Overshadowed the out of this game.
Yeah, so. This is generally a good love game. I've heard great things about this game. It's just that a lot of people complain about how hard it is and how tedious the battle system is.
It's really hard when you haven't, like, been through it.
Exactly. Well, exactly. Then, some people just don't try.
Let's get you changed.
When was this made?
Yeah, I don't think it's going to be, like...
2013, yeah.
2013, yeah. A lot of good games came out in 2013.
Yeah.
So that makes sense. She's 4 years old. There's no more alcohol there, buddy.
Johnny wants his heart, man. Let him drink some.
There was nothing in there.
Get out of here! I'll call Johnny.
You don't want Johnny.
What the fuck that is? They've got the memory of a goldfish.
No, so you're trying to be urban and futuristic, huh? That's how you feel.
The bounty hunter.
Olga Sedova?
Is she dangerous?
Determined. She'll turn the slum inside out.
Yeah,
her,
right?
Yeah, pretty much. That knife does not.
Oh, yeah, here comes the interesting part.
Does not look like a cardboard box.
Her knife says memorize.
Memorize my blade!
This is for you, David.
It'll be the last thing you see.
My blade will remember you!
No, in the next life, you will remember this blade.
It's time for me to remix your memory.
And you'll remember how and you'll remember every last detail of what this blade did to your neck in your next life.
In your next life.
Some bullshit.
Doesn't even say necks, it says neck.
Neck, and your neck life. Oh god. Alright, Olga's memory. Now this part of the game is really interesting to me.
Olga, that just sounds like a name for ogres, and ogres exclusively.
Well, Olga's like, it's like a European name.
I know, it's a very European name, but nowadays it just feels like it belongs to like all ogres.
Yeah, because it does sound like Olga. Ogre. Yeah. Right. Yeah, Olga's does sound like ogre a little bit. I mixed myself up a little bit there. The memory transfusion.
The transfusion of the memory.
I think you need a transfusion more than anyone else.
This is for you, David.
Yeah,
I love the way you looked at me when I did that.
Oh, man. Oh, man.
It made me feel special.
Cat, you're a grown man, and you have the impulsive mindset of a 7-year-old. Holy cow. All right. Fuck you,
okay? when the character looks like this, you don't even need to help him anymore.
Sure. The inevitable shattering of already fragmented personality.
You'll die.
Here. Endorphins should lubricate the process.
I don't trust characters. I don't trust doctors in video games, especially when they look like Dr. Phil.
I don't trust doctors in M-rated video games. Ever. If you see a doctor in a video game, and the video game you're playing just so happens to be rated M, that's how you know that doctor's on some crooked shit.
90% of the time, the doctor is evil.
Yep. And almost every M-rated game. Every single one.
So, like, I don't get this memory transfusion, because she's only giving him the memories that she remembered.
Mm-hmm.
So there'll be gaps in his memory that he cannot, understand.
Mm. I think I remember, there was this one case where... this man had gotten like a pole like through his head, right?
Mm-hmm.
And he survived it, but like it had fucked up his brain so much that he can only remember so much.
Mm-hmm.
And so now he lives, now he lives with his wife and everything now. And like every time he like looks away from her, and like, say for example, he'll be in the same room as his wife. You know, he'll see her, right? He'll look away from her, and then he'll look at her again. He'll be excited to see her. And then he'll run over, hug her, kiss her like he had just seen her for the first time today or something like that. And he does it every single time he looks away from her. But basically, it had done something with his, I think his hippocampus, which is like, hippocampus. So the hippocampus is like the part of your brain where like all your memories are stored or some shit like that. I think so. That might be it. Either that or that's where all your emotions are. But basically, that's what happened to him. It fucked up his brain so much that every time he sees his wife... After he looks away, he thinks he's seeing her for the first time.
All right.
You know, that's kind of sad, to be honest.
Yes.
And, you know, if I was aware of that, I'd be pretty frustrated. Sorry for talking over this cutscene, but...
people who, like, go through the most hell to me are the people who have to, like, have an orgasm, like, once every... Like, every minute of the day.
Wait, what?
It's a medical disorder where, like, some women, like, they get orgasms for, like, no reason, like, every minute of the day.
Oh, that's gotta suck.
Yeah, it is.
That's gotta suck. That's gotta be really uncomfortable too. Like, I don't know how.
That's like a guy like releasing his semen like every other minute.
That would suck, dude. Yeah, but someone's you know, sometimes your sex drive is just really, really
broken.
Yeah, like it's so strong that it becomes broken, basically. You know, a lot of people have those kind of problems. All right, so I don't remember every little detail here, so you might want to pay attention. Close attention, unless you remember what to do.
Hey, they don't
inevitable shattering.
I mean, yeah, we've played. Yeah, you've played this game before. No surprise there. Well, they do now, and for those who are seeing this for the first time, like it's not like we're saying anything that's gonna spoil this. You know, it's okay to remember things or admit that you have played this game before. In fact, most of the games that I'm less playing, I've played it before. But alright, so, which one do you disable first? I forgot.
Taco.
Memorial flight.
Insertion.
No, I don't think you have to grab things. I think that's that will probably kill him.
That's the point.
Number one, when you like did that, but then like you didn't.
Oh wait, wrong person. Wrong person.
Whoa, whoa, whoa!
Wrong person.
Whoa.
Ew.
That was terrible.
That was an accident.
Oh man.
Didn't mean to do that one.
There you go.
Memorial Fluxin. No, stop it. It's not what I wanted you to do.
It's just
bad machine.
How you see is her over there struggling, like, oh no.
Bad machine. Uh-huh. Yeah, do all that struggling.
Do all the struggle. Struggle, damn. Struggle.
I want you to come. Die with me.
All right, now what?
I got two more things I need to do. Yes! That's it. Good boy. Good boy.
Holy shit. Cat, you diabolical genius.
Do it. Now I see you there. Release!
So we're basically altering Olga's memories to believe that the doctor killed...
Yes!
...killed him when really Nilin did it?
Yes!
Okay. Yeah, that makes sense.
Release the beast.
Scum.
My eyes.
God damn.
You'll never generate to die.
No. I remember the last time we let's play this, it took you a little bit long.
Oh yeah, it took me like an hour.
It didn't take you that long.
I mean, it was not when I let's played, it was off screen. It took
an
hour.
No, cause I remember like the first time we recorded these, it took you a little bit longer than this.
Oh. Yeah, it took me a little longer because I did play this before we last played.
Yeah.
Nice.
So, you know, now that you have, you know, you kind
of... I have the memory of everything.
Except for the stuff you didn't get to yet.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Which I'm only on chapter 2 right now.
Okay, so yeah, he's complete... He, you know, as soon as we get past chapter 2, he'll be as blind as everyone else here. Well, as everyone else watching. Alright, so... none of that's been all altered.
Yeah, take your little cookie cutter knife away from me before you give yourself a paper cut.
Yes.
And we can continue on with our day.
Thank you.
Thank you very much for complying.
Well, there's a turnaround. I mean, a happy turn up. For everyone.
I know Olga has her own reasons. Actually, just the one reason.
The great Olga Sedova siding with the Errorist Revolution. Must be something in the water.
She's been corrupted with broken memories.
You were young and quick on your feet. Just because you're not on my list doesn't make us drinking buddies.
I can don't also sweat people's it. Memories. I
canceled the romantic weekend for Jesus. But Nilin has a rendezvous with high society, and the root is alive with surveillance. You got any ideas?
Oh, I got better than ideas.
That's the Nilin I know. A magician. Nobody can turn heads quite like you.
First you hit
me. Someone just heard that.
Then you ruin my little business. You want a love-hate relationship, you got
So I guess only we can
Whatever.
Do that, huh?
We're wasting what? Time.
We can hear your edge.
Yeah.
Still.
Thanks, Tommy, truly.
You know, you could just go into the
lost
it,
sweetheart.
And, like, get yours back.
You know,
that sounds like a very... You know what?
That would make Everybody's this much, this whole journey of hers
like,
much...
Once you get the glove, you could just go into the memories of all the
Yep. Probably shouldn't say things like that so early into the let's play.
Because, like, it's a plot hole.
I mean,
really. Because our mission is to get our memories back, but these people remember us.
Why are you talking so low?
Because I am stuck in like an endless mind loop.
Yeah, you're thinking too hard. That's...
Oh yeah, I made it to Hoenn last night.
Oh, you did?
Yeah.
How's that go?
It's going well. I'm trying to find a route.
Yeah, he's playing Pokemon Revolution. It's like an online
It's an online community. It's an online Pokemon community where everyone plays Pokemon together and see each other and make guilds and BS.
Yeah, it's like an MMO for Pokemon, basically.
Yes, it is very good. Very good. They're adding Sinnoh,
that's nice.
Making it fertile for the seeds of revolution.
All this exposition and da-ba-da-ba-da.
It's his friendship that has been clinging to my drifting thoughts. Why did our enemies erase my memory? Am I really that dangerous? In my chest, my throat, on the tips of my fingers, I can feel the throb of the power that scares them so. Scares me, too. The power to take what someone is, their memories, and bend them to my will. To rewrite their history. To play God. The mere thought sends me reeling. If this ability really is the core of who I once was, then I must relearn what has been taken from me. I must master this talent.
Alright, so that's the end of the episode 2. Yeah, I know, Kat, you're tired of seeing the same shit over and over again, so I understand how you feel there. But, you know, since we're less playing, we gotta kind of, you know, sit through this. You know, especially the stuff we've seen already. We need to, you know, just bear with it, basically. You can track the number of SAT patches and focus boosts. You can, yeah, okay. Had fun there?
Yes!
Yeah, he was balancing his key lime soda bottle on his head.
Good hunting.
I could do with a guide.
No.
No can do. Family business to take care of.
Your first target's name is Carrie Sheridan. I need some confidential codes hidden in her memory.
Who is she?
The most famous architect in Neo-Paris. Stored in her brain is every detail of every building she's designed.
How do I find her?
Your contact goes by the name of Bad Request. He's waiting on the last floor of the San Michel Rotunda.
Alrighty. So, our target is Carrie Sheridan.
I don't get the fashion designers for necklaces, because they don't give them pockets.
Keep it cool. Yeah, I always find that kind of weird.
But they deserve pockets more than anyone else. But you know, functionality overall.
Behold the privileged.
Functionality, I guess.
Safe with their little comforts, while others live in suffering, a few meters from their barricade.
No one chooses which side of the firewall to grow up on.
It's not their selfishness that I condemn, sister. It's their eagerness to forget everything that bothers them.
Whoa, how do you know that? Are you actually talking to these people? No. All right, then. Great. I will break you. Like the pink strawberry you are.
Her dress kind of reminds me. Do you remember when, over the summer we went to the, that Sanford Brown, right?
I didn't go.
Oh, yeah, that's right, you didn't go. Basically,
where are you going?
During our summer job, we went to Sanford Brown University.
I'm right here.
A couple students were showing us, like, the dresses they were designing, and, a couple of them were using, like, waterproof material, the stuff you use for, like, for scuba diving suits. And, like, the dress was kind of similar to that right there. And basically, you could wear this dress and you could, like, go swimming in it.
Don't you walk away from me. No.
But, yeah.
I'm right here.
The future of fashion is nearing.
Come here. Come on. You pink strawberry wannabe little mutt. Oh, if I can fight you right now, I will. Ah! All right. This has been Kat.
And this has been Kido.
And I really hate this lady!
And see you guys in episode 3 of Remember Me. Peace out.